The Samsung Galaxy S10 is the first phone from the Galaxy series that actually ships with a USB power delivery charger. Previously, only the Google Pixel phones had shipped with a 18-watt USB power delivery charger. In Samsung's case, their first PD charger actually supports USB power delivery 3.0 and 25 watts of power through the new programmable power supply negotiation mechanism that is defined in the new PD 3.0 standard. To analyze how the Galaxy S10 5G charges with this PPS charger, we'll use the same GRL A1 and PowerSuite Pro application that we had used in a previous post. Using the same setup as before, where we have the GRL battery monitor application installed on the Galaxy S10 5G. The PowerSuite Pro application is pulling from that app the phone's battery temperature, charging level, voltage, and current. Speeding up the entire recording to show how the phone charges from 3% to 100%, we can then easily compare the charging behavior between the Galaxy S10 5G and its cousin, the S10 Plus. What we can see is that while both phone displays are on and they're Wi-Fi active, the Galaxy S10 5G actually charges about 30 to 40% faster compared to the S10 Plus. Now, what's amazing is that the faster charging is achieved without compromising on the battery temperature. If we overlay the charging graphs of the Galaxy S10 5G and the S10 Plus on top of each other, we can actually see how the charging profile of the 5G is much faster than the S10 Plus, while the overall charging temperature profile is almost identical and stays well below 35 degrees Celsius. By contrast, the Google Pixel 3 XL is able to charge a little bit faster, however, the battery temperature does increase over 40 degrees Celsius over different periods of time. Now we can see how this is achieved by placing two GRL A1 VBUS plots side by side. We can compare the VBUS voltage levels and the power levels right next to each other. And here it's pretty obvious to see how the Galaxy S10 5G is able to use initially 25 watts of power and then later on a 9 watt sustained power for charging, whereas the Galaxy S10 Plus uses 15 watts of initial charging followed by a 6 watt sustained charging level. On this plot, you can also see the differences between USB PD 2.0, which uses fixed VBUS voltage levels, and the new USB PD 3.0 standard, which the 5G uses, which is able to take advantage of variable VBUS voltage levels depending on the temperature and charging optimization requirements of the phone. If we take a look at the USB PD protocol traces from the A1 software, we can see that the variable voltages are the result of the S10 5G phone making constant requests for different voltages and current from the charger, while the Galaxy S10 Plus can only make a couple requests that cover fixed voltages. With the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G highlighting the benefits of using USB power delivery 3.0 and PPS-based charging, we expect to see more and more phones include in-box PD3 PPS chargers in the future.